Hello everyone. Hope you all are happy and healthy. Welcome to your English class. Today we will study chapter number 3, A Precious Gift. Students, precious means valuable or something which is of great importance or value. So, as the name reflects, this chapter is about a gift which holds a very great value or importance. And at the end, you will also learn a great lesson or message through this chapter. So let's begin. Chapter number 3, A Precious Gift. Underline the word precious in your books with pencil and write its meaning, valuable. So students, here is an activity given at the beginning of this chapter also. And you can see a grid over here which contains different alphabets. And from this grid, you have to find out these words which are written on the top. You can see that in pink box, words are given: thief, bandit, criminal, pirate, robber, and crook. These six words are given, and from this grid, you have to make these six words. Let me show you how we have to do this activity. You can see on this page now that I have marked the word thief from the grid. So I have done this first one to show you so that you can do the rest on your own. So I hope that you will do the rest on your own. Let's start our chapter. First I will read and after that I will explain. What would you call a precious birthday gift? Something made of gold or silver, or can it be something else? Mr. Jain was a very wealthy merchant. He had a big family and a lot of friends. Every year on his birthday, the 10th of August, they all came to his house with flowers and gifts. They had dinner with him and enjoyed themselves. So students, first stanza of the chapter gives us a description of Mr. Jain. Who was Mr. Jain? Mr. Jain was a very wealthy merchant. Wealthy means rich, and merchant means a trader or a person who buys or sells goods for profit. So Mr. Jain was a very rich merchant or trader, and he had a big family and lots of friends. And every year on 10th of August, Mr. Jain used to celebrate his birthday, and on that day, all his relatives, friends used to came to his house and have dinner with him. And he used to bring so many gifts and flowers for Mr. Jain. Now let's study the second stanza. It was after midnight and Mr. Jain's birthday party was just over. He was alone in his living room. He picked up a bouquet of roses. As he was smelling the flowers, he saw the shadow of a head on the table. He knew there was a thief in the room. He knew the thief was hiding among the wooden beams of the ceiling. He called out to his cook, "Bring back all the dishes. One of my guests has not had his dinner." So students, these lines tells us that it was time after midnight, and Mr. Jain has just finished his birthday party, and while all his guests, after having the dinner with him, left for their houses, Mr. Jain was sitting alone in his living room. So while he was sitting there, he picked up a bouquet of roses from a table which was in front of him, and he started smelling the flowers. It was a bouquet of roses, and he started smelling those roses. And while he was smelling those roses, he saw a shadow of head on the table, on that table from which he has just picked the bouquet of roses. And on seeing that shadow, Mr. Jain immediately understood that there is a thief. There is a thief hiding in the wooden beams of the ceiling. Wooden beams means, students, wooden logs. You can see in the picture which is given on page number 37. Above picture, you can see the wooden beams on which a thief is hiding. And on seeing and on understanding that a thief is there in my living room, Mr. Jain quickly called out to his servant or cook, and he said to him that bring back all the food because one of my guests is still left from having the dinner. So let's read the next para. The cook obeyed his master. He put lots of tasty dishes on the table and left. Mr. Jain then looked up at the man in the ceiling and said, "Thank you for coming to my house on my birthday. Please come down and have something to eat." So students, this para shows us the kindness of Mr. Jain. How much kind-hearted, how much generous Mr. Jain was. Because on seeing a thief, instead of shouting or calling the police, he ordered the food. He asked his cook to bring the food. And after the cook served the food, he called out to this thief that please come down. First of all, he thanked him for coming on his birthday. And after that, he asked him to please come down and have some food. Now let's read further on the next page. The thief was starving. He looked at the mouth-watering dishes and came down. He sat at the table and had a big meal. Mr. Jain was an excellent host and talked to him politely. Before the thief left, Mr. Jain gave him a bag of silver coins and said, "Accept this small gift from me." So students, what happened next when Mr. Jain called this thief to come down and have something to eat? The thief came down. And at that time, the thief was starving. Starving means dying from hunger or very hungry. So as he was very hungry, the thief was very hungry. He sat down to eat the food and he ate lots of food. And Mr. Jain was very good host. You can say he was treating him very nicely. He was talking to him very politely. And after having the food, after having the dinner, when the thief was about to leave, Mr. Jain gave him a bag which was containing silver coins, and he said that accept this small gift from me. So students, this stanza also tells us the greatness of Mr. Jain, who treated a thief in such a nice, in such a polite way. Now let's read further. Next para. Several years went by. It was the 10th of August. There was a big party at Mr. Jain's house. By 12 o'clock, his guests had left. At 12:30, the bell rang and a stranger came in. He was carrying a lovely bouquet of white roses and a gift. Now students, this para tells us that several years went by, and several years passes from that incident when Mr. Jain fed a thief. And after several years, now again it was Mr. Jain's birthday on 10th of August, and Mr. Jain has just celebrated a grand birthday party at his house. And before 12 o'clock at night, all his guests has left for their houses. And after half an hour, about 12:30 o'clock at night, Mr. Jain's house bell rang and a stranger came inside the house. The stranger was carrying two things with him, a bouquet of white roses and a gift. Now let's read the next para. He went up to Mr. Jain and gave him the flowers and the gift. Mr. Jain unwrapped the gift and found a velvet bag. Inside the bag, there was a gold coin. After thanking the stranger, Mr. Jain asked him, "Why have you given me this expensive gift?" So students, that stranger who came inside Mr. Jain's house went to Mr. Jain and he gave him those flowers and that gift. Mr. Jain thanked him and he started unwrapping. Unwrap means to open. And he started opening the gift. And after opening the gift, he found that in that gift there was a velvet bag. And inside that velvet bag there was a gold coin. So on seeing that gold coin, Mr. Jain was a bit surprised. He was thinking that who is this man who is not known to me? He's a stranger and he's given me such an expensive gift. So he asked the stranger that, "Why have you given me this expensive gift?" Expensive means something which is very costly. Let's study the next para to know what was the reply of that stranger. "Many years ago," the stranger said, "you were kind to me on your birthday, gave me a bag of silver coins and treated me as an honored guest." Mr. Jain remembered the man in the ceiling. He said, "Please have dinner with me again tonight. By what name should I call you?" So when Mr. Jain asked this stranger that why have you given me this costly gift, the stranger replied that many years ago when I came on your birthday, you were so kind to me. You gave me a bag full of silver coins and you also treated me as an honored guest. Honored means, students, respected. And he said, the stranger said that you treated me so with so much respect and so much kindness. And after hearing these words of silver coins and respect and on his birthday, Mr. Jain suddenly remembered that incident on which took place several years before, and when he fed a thief. And on remembering that incident, Mr. Jain again asked this stranger to have dinner with him for one more time, and he also asked the stranger that what is your name. Now let's read further. "Why should you know my name, sir?" asked the stranger. Years ago you invited me to have dinner with you. I was a thief. Now I am an honest man. I work hard and earn my livelihood. Your goodness, your kindness has changed my life." So when Mr. Jain asked the stranger's name, the stranger replied that, "Sir, why do you want to know my name now? When I came to your house years ago and you gave me the food, you treated me so nicely, and at that time I was a thief. You didn't ask my name then, and now you wanted to know my name when I am an honest man. I used to work hard to earn my living, and your goodness and your attitude which you show me, your kindness, your generosity has changed my life." Now let's read the last para of this chapter. Mr. Jain was deeply moved. "I am proud of you," he said. "One little act of kindness has multiplied 100-fold. Then he said, "You have given me the most precious birthday gift I have ever received." So the last para tells us that on hearing the stranger's word that from a thief he has changed into an honest man, Mr. Jain was deeply moved. Deeply moved means, it means, students, emotionally affected, or you can say deeply touched by the words. And he said to that stranger that, "I am very proud of you. I am feeling very happy and I am very proud of you." Further, he added that one little act of kindness has multiplied 100-fold. This sentence means that one small act of kindness has returned to him in 100 times better way. How? Because he was kind at a time several years ago when he fed that thief. Instead of calling the police or shouting on the thief or beating him, he politely have dinner with him, and in return that thief has changed into an honest man. He was so much affected with the behavior, with the kindness of Mr. Jain, that he changed his perception of living, and from a thief he became an honest man. So Mr. Jain said that, "I have done so little kindness to you, but you have returned that to me in 100 times better way by changing yourself, by changing your way of living." And after that he said to that stranger, to that thief who was now an honest man, that, "You have given me the most precious, most expensive, most valuable birthday gift which I have ever received, which I have received so far." And here, by precious gift, by precious birthday gift, Mr. Jain means that the conversion of that thief into an honest man, and he did not mean about that gold coin. Friends, this was all in this beautiful story, which gives us a very nice message, very nice lesson, that we should always be kind towards others. We should always show kindness and politeness towards others, because our little politeness, our little kindness can change a person's perception or way of living. So I hope, students, you have understood this chapter nicely. We'll meet you on the next turn. Till then, take care and be kind.